My insurance has gone up by £9.50. Hey guys, how are you guys doing? Welcome back to yet again a brand new video. For today's video, it's going to be a sit-down talking one. There's not going to be any fancy bloody editing or anything. So if you guys don't like talking videos, click off the video. It might be a topic that you want to hear, so watch it if it is. But so basically, right, if you guys didn't know, I have actually just started to modify my baby, right? And if we crack open the bonnet, we have actually got an air filter in my car, a Ram air filter, which obviously you need to declare on your insurance. Oh, and also I've actually put an exhaust on the car. However, that is now off. And I'm waiting on a new one. So a lot of people wondering how much is it now with an air filter and an exhaust on the car. And I'm about to go into that in today's video. Oh, I've also forgot to mention all the hybrid turbos, you know, my stage 2 intercooler, you know, my 15 ton gold plated alloys. I just want to quickly say, obviously I'm not an insurance company. I do not know how this fucking shit works. Nobody knows how this shit works, you know? So anything I say in this video, it is not facts. It is not, I don't know. Now let me quickly explain before I actually go into the price and everything. But you have to declare your modification on the car, boys. Honestly, if you've got an exhaust on the car, declare it. It will be so much better paying maybe £200 extra on your insurance to have an exhaust than getting in a crash and your insurance is invalid because you've got an exhaust on the car without telling them, you know? You never know when Margaret's gonna come around fucking whizzing around the corner at 60 miles per hour and go into your car with her wheelchair. So come on. Now I'm gonna go on to the actual price of how much I paid for my modified insurance, basically. But quickly, you know, I've got to put in the promo here. If you guys are looking for a lanyard, I've just released my own sort of brand, and that is Ricer, boys. Wait, is this the right way? This is my lanyard, my personalized lanyard. And yeah, it's honestly fire. Links in the description. So my insurance before the modifications was £737, and after putting all the hybrid turbos, you know, the whizzy wish wash things, joking, only putting on the air filter and the exhaust, my insurance has gone up by £9.50. My insurance has genuinely gone up by £9.50 from having these modifications on the car. Legally, it's in my policy, like £9.50, that's all it takes. So I'm gonna go more into the price, but I have to get this little piece of information out there right now. I'm not gonna be telling you guys who I'm insured with. And I know. It's like getting catfished by a girl and it turns out to be Jar Jar Binks or something. I know, it's like throwing spaghetti at a dartboard. You know, I know it's annoying that I can't tell you guys who I'm with. I can tell you guys who I'm with. I don't care if people know. But
what?
Last year, I obviously told everyone I was with Morton Smart Wheels. And obviously, I had a bit of issues but with telling people, you know. It's something I should probably keep private. So I'm going to keep private. And hopefully, you guys understand that. All I can say is I'm with one of the biggest companies in the UK, you know. I'm like, white as fuck right now. Right, so my insurance actually went up £9.50. And obviously, I'm with a big company, you know. I'm not with modified insurance, like a specific modified insurance company. So then obviously I took out an insurance policy with, you know, this company that I'm with, and I asked them on live chat, you know, can I add a exhaust and an air filter to the car, to my policy? And they basically said no.
Bitch, what the fuck?
I think they were like, we're unable to do that or something like that. After going back and forth, they said that we can put the modification onto the car so that we know it's on the car. However, it won't be covered by the insurance. So for example, if I had a £5,000 exhaust on this tuk-tuk and I got in a crash and that £5,000 exhaust was destroyed, basically, my insurance would not pay out £5,000 for that exhaust. They would pay for the whole car if it was obviously, you know, somebody else's fault or something. I don't really know. Basically, I paid £9.50, which is even an admin fee for them doing it. It's not an actual fee. So I paid £9.50 just for them to, like, know that I have these fucking modifications on the car. The brum brum exhaust and the air filter and the Yeah, air filter. So yeah, pretty much, I'm pretty sure that's how it works for my insurance.
Before you guys go off and, you know, buy an exhaust or something, £9.50 is most likely not going to be your insurance price. Most likely, you guys are going to get probably quotes for, like, I'm talking upwards of £75 increase. Like, yes, that is a lot of McDonald's and KFCs, but it'll be worth it, boys. So I don't know how I got it down to £9.50. I'm not no magician. It's probably because I'm Asian or something. But yeah, obviously, having an exhaust on the car and an air filter, it should have made my insurance go like skyrocket. It should have been, at least I'm saying, it should have went up £75. But I don't fucking know why. Why it hasn't. Obviously, having an exhaust on the car and an air filter makes you more of a risk to the insurance company. So I'm not 100% sure why it's gone up £9.50. But before anybody expects £9.50 increases, you guys might, but I don't know. I'm not a wizard. I'm not a fucking wizard, Harry.
So before I actually took out the quote, boys, I hit up my guys, the modified insurance companies, and I asked them all for quotes. The cheapest that I got was 1.2k. So £1,200 was the cheapest modification insurance that I could get. Almost double what my insurance is now. I'm not 100% sure on what modifications companies are like different from real companies, you know, mainstream insurers. I'm pretty sure they obviously cover it. If it was to be broken or something, they'd pay out. And also, I guess, like, these mainstream insurers won't cover a bloody hybrid turbo. They probably wouldn't allow it. They wouldn't charge you £9.50 to have a hybrid turbo on. They'd probably tell you to go fuck yourself. So, I believe that's what modification insurance is kind of made for. I'm not 100% sure. Again, I'm not an insurer. Oh, all I would say is if you want your car to be heavily modified, I would say go for a modification company. If you just want a few things added to the car, maybe an exhaust, an air filter on the car, go to a mainstream company. I'm just going to use this as an example, boys. LV are a big company here in the UK. I'm not 100% sure on how much they charge for modifications, etc. However, they do take modifications. I mean, on their website, they do say that they take aftermarket modifications, but obviously you're going to have to research that a little bit more. But all I would say is to find a company that does aftermarket modification cover, or like they're allowed to be on the car, go on to GoCompare, and you can literally add your modifications on there and it will come up with all the companies that will insure you, basically. And yeah, I'm not sure how it completely works, but if you do go to your insurance company, just ask them if you can declare it on your insurance and not actually add it. Again though, really not 100% sure on how it all works. So basically what you took from this is don't believe anything I just said. But yeah, pretty sure most companies will allow aftermarket things, you know. I know that More Than Smart Wheels did not allow anything, pretty much. They didn't allow me to get my exhaust. They didn't allow me to get my air filter. You might have to look around for the companies that actually will allow you to declare it on the insurance. I'm not sure about tuning or anything else. If I was to get a tune on the car or something, if I told them, I'm not sure if it would go up like £100 or something, but I doubt it. So yeah, hopefully you guys did enjoy this video. I mean, I know it's a really shitty sit down boring video, but yeah, it's a video that I wanted to create specifically. So yeah, hopefully you guys did enjoy this video. Follow me on Instagram @_otherstuff if you did enjoy. Also, go cop yourself a lanyard. Boys, these are fire as fuck. Genuinely, look at that. Ricer, boys. Proper nice quality. Link in the description, boys. Anyway, also subscribe if you are new, and that's it, basically. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you guys did enjoy and took something out of this. Anyway, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. And I'll see you later, please, for my next video.